Thank you. I first met John when I was on the bus in middle school, and I remember the year after I met him, he was at my birthday party, and I'll never forget that night.
My name's Dominic. I first met John when I was like 5 or 6. Me and him, we grew up together. He was pretty much my cousin.
I've known John pretty much my whole life. Here in the past 2 years, it was practically me and him every weekend, trying to hang out.
We used to have fun all the time. Like, he made everyone at school laugh. He was the only reason that half the people wanted to go to school, just because he'd tell everybody jokes, keep everything going, and he keep everybody uplifted.
I first met John back when we were really young. I was maybe 5 and he was probably about 4, so we've been friends for an extremely long time, and you know, losing a friend like that really sucked. I think some of the best times we have was back when we used to go dirt biking all the time. We used to ride dirt bikes up and down a dirt path, go trailing and everything every day, and losing him was like losing a brother.
I met him in middle school, and we always rode four-wheelers and dirt bikes and stuff together, and he liked to forget putting oil in dirt bike and get stuck on the side of the road.
Probably just sitting by the fire pit wrestling around at his house. Always did that. We were either riding four-wheelers, playing with trucks, all sorts of stuff. We just did a lot of things together. I mean, we basically, for the last 6, 7, 8 years, we've every weekend, either at my house, his house, somewhere like that.
Thank you. was a pretty great kid, and I do miss him. He was my sister's ex-boyfriend, and I went to the Lax concert with him. He was a good kid. He helped me at my truck a little bit, and I miss him.
I remember when Nathan got his stacks. He came up to Zebulon to come hang out with everyone. And me, Nathan, and John went on the freeway and topped at his truck, and it was just outrageously loud. And it was the best memory I have of him. All of us laughing. It was a great time.
I started sitting with him at lunch. He really didn't say nothing much to me. And he started picking on me just for fun. Started talking to him a little bit more every once in a while, and before we knew it, we were friends. I had a lot of people that picked on me in school, and he never really, when I was around him, ain't nobody picked on me because he had my back and I had his. And it kind of makes me feel bad that he's gone now, because now I miss him more than ever.
I knew John since sixth grade. He would do anything for anybody at any time. He would always pick on people in a good way, like joke around and all. And he was just a great dude to hang around. And I don't know what to say, he's missing.
Matter of fact, it was this year, man. In third period, we used to have a ball, man. We used to mess around in class, you know, get on the teacher's nerves, pick on people. You know, he was my boy. I did everything with him. After school, you know, we go on rides, we go on, you know, go hunting, go fishing. You know, he was my boy. I did everything with him. And when I heard, you know, he got in the wreck, I was there as soon as I heard I was there. I just couldn't believe it when I found out he passed away, and I'm gonna miss him forever. He's my boy.
My best friend, just don't know what to do without him, you know. And this whole day right here made it for him, you know.
I'm Jennifer Fleming. I have known John since he was probably 3 years old. He walked in class with Sylvia. Dalton and Sylvia were in kindergarten together, so I've known him since he was little, walking in school. So. Probably one of my great memories was of just seeing him grow over the years, just watching him. Gosh, buddy. Seems like all the good memories get blurred by the last memory, so that makes it hard. I'm very grateful that I had Sylvia and Millie's phone number in my phone that day. I really wished I would have thought and called the school in time. Millie, I hate that I didn't, but I tried to do all I could do that day. I watched over him just like he was mine. I hope that this is a good event for you guys. We tried our best. Know that we love you and we'll always be here for you. I know John is always going to watch over Dalton, and I'm glad for that. And I hope that this helps you all with some peace too, and it shows you just how much everybody else loved John too.
My favorite memory of John, I have so many it's hard to choose from, but when John got his 86 Ford truck, he was very proud of that truck, and he came home one day and says, Mom, you gotta come outside. So you went running out the door, and it's covered in mud, head to toe, he's covered in mud. And it was the funniest thing to us because he said, Mom, I got the truck that can do it now. So that was my best memory. And we are restoring his truck in the process now. It's in the shop to be painted. So we're hoping everybody will be able to see it around town coming up. He'll have a personalized plate on it called John Boys. So we hope that y'all can see it, take a wave out at us. We'll be glad to see you.
I'm sorry that you guys had to go through this. I know that it's hard. If y'all need anything, you just let me know. I'll be there. And that's anything. I don't care if it's 2 o'clock in the morning, you can call me. I don't care if you're sick, you need me to come make you a bowl of soup, I'll be there.
I'm sorry for the family's loss. I share that pain because I have a loss in my family as well. And it still hurts me to this day that John's gone. Well, I'd give anything for 5 minutes with John Perry.
I'm so sorry for your loss. Like, this hurts me the most. I know I can't imagine what it's doing to y'all.
I love you, Johnny and Millie.
I'm sorry that it happened, and I wish it didn't. And I wish he'd still be here with us, because it'd be a lot better if he was here. It'd be so much funner.
Millie, Johnny, Sylvia, I'm sorry for your loss. I know John's looking over us. I try my best to raise money and do for y'all. Even though I'm sick today and been sick last week and so, I made it still. He's looking over us. I want to thank everybody coming out. If it weren't for y'all or me, this wouldn't have happened. People came from all around the area. Thank you for that. I'm hearing people coming from Durham, Raleigh, Curry, Benson, Greensboro, ECU, everywhere. And thank you for all coming out and making this happen.
To all the Bows, y'all mean a lot to us. You have helped me and Johnny get through some tough times without these kids coming over for birthdays, Christmas. Valentine's Day was our first court date. Without these guys coming, you know who you are, all the Bows that have been there through John, elementary school and up, new friends and old. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I hope to continue to see you when you go off to college. Can't wait till graduation. Thank y'all.